lot of work to do to this one. We got it pretty cheap, but needs a lot. Let's get busy on it. Get hooked up. There she is. Gonna paint it white. Now it's time to break out the torch. Booger welded on there. I had to fill a gap in there, so yeah, it looks real good. But it doesn't matter. I'm gonna grind it down. Finally got the fenders all on. I had to move these brackets forward. They were back here. These fenders are a little bit narrower, but actually fits better. I'm gonna have to remake the backing plates back here. Splash shield, whatever you call it. Traced one out this way. And then I need a reverse one. So flip that. And there. Now I'm gonna cut these. And test fitting. I didn't account for the fender curving right there. So I'm gonna have to notch this out a little more. Got this side to match. Pretty close anyway. All right, time to wipe her down. I'm gonna do a little wire brushing quickly and move it out of the way, get all this stuff off here and spray it. And now I'm gonna drill the holes for the, I got the little LED 3/4 lights. On to the next several. Well, here it is after painting, after putting the lights in, fenders, wheels. I redid the hubs, which I didn't film that. Obviously, it's way too greasy and trying to record at the same time. But these wheels actually come off of this truck when I bought it. That's what was on it. So I had those left over. Since it's an 8-lug trailer, guess what? Those fit. I did have to put a small wheel spacer on there to keep it from rubbing the frame, but it's just a little thin one, so it should be all right. I do still have to do the floor and the backing plates, which I may or may not even mess with. I haven't really had an issue. I've been using it for a few months now, and really hadn't had any issues with the floor either, but missing that piece, and that one piece up there is rotten, so I am eventually gonna replace all this whenever lumber goes down, if it ever does. Then I'm gonna paint these ramps black because they get way too dirty. Everything else is washable, but those are not. But yeah, I got the LED taillights, got the brakes working, got the little LED 3/4 markers on there, which look great at night. I'll get some video of that when it gets dark and put it on there. I do still need to fix the little winch cable right there, but other than that, winch works great. It's just a 5,000-pound, I think. Let's see, 5,500-pound. Yeah, but it works great. I did have to reinforce the back right there a little to keep it from twisting up, but it works good. I am gonna repaint this stuff. whenever it warms up. But there she is. I've got about $2,800 in this whole deal, and still need to do the floor, so that's probably another $300 or so. But a trailer like this, brand new, is probably around $6,000 right now. Maybe a hair more than that. With the 8-lug axles, probably is more than that. But there it is, guys. Get out there and get your hands dirty. Here it is at night with the lights on. I love these LEDs. This made the whole trailer look better. Awesome. God bless.